Let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have meant to do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all beings and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May the power of the Holy Spirit come to us, we pray, Lord, that we may keep your will faithfully in mind and express it in a devout way of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
This morning's Mass is being offered for Dee Lovato Sr. and Betty Wood.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul traveled through the interior of the country and down to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. He said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They answered him, "We have never heard that there is a Holy Spirit." He said, "How were you baptized?" They replied, "With the baptism of John." Paul then said, "John baptized with a baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there were about 12 men. He entered the synagogue and for 3 months debated boldly with persuasive arguments about the kingdom of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. A smoke is driven away, so as they are driven, as wax melts before the fire. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. But the just rejoice and exalt before God. They are glad and rejoice. Sing to God, chant praise to his name, whose name is the Lord.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
The father of orphans and the defender of widows is God in his holy dwelling. God gives a home to the forsaken. He leads forth prisoners to prosperity. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Each of you will be scattered to his own home, and you will leave me alone. But I am not alone, because the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you might have peace in me. In the world, you will have trouble. But take courage. I have conquered. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Christ. We're coming upon the week when we, this next Sunday is Pentecost Sunday. And we will read the story of when the Holy Spirit descended upon the apostles in a spectacular and exciting way. It came upon the apostles when they were all covered up in fear, praying, wondering how they were going to survive. Until the Holy Spirit came in the form as promised by Jesus, that he would send them the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will teach them all they need to know and direct them in all the things that they have to do to be evangelists, we call them now. But it's simply just telling the story of Jesus and what he did. There are times in our life, even in childhood, when we get excited. And God be praised if we are excited with something that leads us to experiencing joy and peace, calmness, all the things that the Holy Spirit promises. I have to go to my Palomar Catechism and read what are the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. It's in one of the letters to the Ephesians, and I have to bring that too. I can't quote a lot of scripture by heart, But I know that when there are times when I open the scriptures, they do nothing for me. That means that I have other things on my mind besides the Word of God and the actions of God. There are lots of things that get us excited, as we know, as when we are growing up. Especially when we are at exciting events. In high school, we had a club filled with the spirit of Franklin High School. No more white sweaters, a little script letter F on there. And boy, when they went to a rally, Mr. Gallagher at one time pointed to the roof, because it seemed to be trembling with the yells of people in that auditorium. The Holy Spirit sometimes reaches us in quiet ways, when no matter what happens in life, we are at peace. And that's what we continue to pray for. Jesus was true to his word. You and I, all who believe in him, have that Holy Spirit. And it doesn't matter what mood we're in, somehow he is going to get through to us and tell us, don't worry, everything's going to be okay. All you need to do is go and do the things that you're used to doing. Have your cup of coffee. Send your children off to school when you go to work. And be at peace at work. And when you leave work, come home. Say a short little prayer to Jesus and thank him for all that you've done that day. And then go home and enjoy the peace of your home. That's the Spirit of God that works in you. And so, don't let the things, your personality, or the things that are going on in the world keep you in a spirit of distraction. The Holy Spirit will lead you back to Jesus, and you will hear the words of Jesus as you heard them in this reading today. Never mind. I have told you this, that you might have peace in me in the world. You will have trouble, but take courage. I have overcome the world. For the church, for Pope Francis and Bishop Cotto, that they will guide us in our pursuit of the kingdom of God, we pray to the Lord. For our government leaders, both national and local, that they may be advocates for the most vulnerable among us, making decisions that protect the common good, we pray to the Lord. For our community here at St. Bernardus, that we may grow in faith and confidence that God is present among us, and that we might be agents of that presence in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the end of the COVID-19 pandemic and all the sick, may they be filled with God's grace, receive healing, and be surrounded by a supportive and loving community.
Lord, hear our prayers.
I will pray for all those who are sick today, that you may use all those who have the ability to heal and to restore our lives, that you be with them, and that you ask the prayers of those who call on you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands. Praise and glory to your name. For I will do all this for you.
May this unblemished sacrifice purify us, O Lord, and impart to our minds the force of grace from on high to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to claim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with passion joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers of the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up. Chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace. The Lord be always with you.
Amen. Your spirit.
Let's talk to one another, sign the Lord's peace.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you. lips is my love, and you know when I sing and where I stand. Your hands are upon me, protecting me from pain, keeping me from harm. Oh, I know.
I will not leave you orphans, says the Lord. I will come to you again, and your heart will rejoice. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord. And lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Grant this to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The man ascended, let's go in peace. Love and serve the Lord and one more.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our refuge against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God continue to be my humble prayer. To thou, Prince of Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking.